So this video is created by one of your friends, and I need a kodri yestana kodtira kodri video create those who are having a hobby. Okay, in the previous class we had begin with the introduction of this half wave rectifier. So the circuit diagram of half wave rectifier, it is as shown in the figure. So along with the input and output waveforms, so it is a positive half wave rectifier circuit which is used to produce wave with only positive cycles by removing all negative cycles of the input. So what is the demand of the output? So the requirement, it is we need only one part of the input signal. So as I am going to apply the sine wave at the input side, so output I want only positive cycles, I don't want negative cycle in the signal. Means I want rectification, or you may say I want to remove unwanted signals. Okay, so there we are going to use these rectifier circuits where we want to remove unwanted signals. Okay, unwanted signals within the input signal. So if you say where you are going to observe these things, means if you observe at your audio, okay, in your speaker, you are going to find varieties of signals, okay, varieties of outputs. But obviously if I go for from my end, so my voice is there, my voice signal is there, plus fan sound is also there. Okay, so both signals are mixed up and they are created only one signal. Okay, that signal is reaching your device. Okay, what is going to happen at the end of this signal? What you are going to hear? It is only my voice. What about that fan signal? So it will be removed. Nothing but what? Filtering process will be there. So before filtering, we are going to perform rectification. So we are going to remove unwanted signals. Okay, so here amplitude of the output is equal to the input with negative cycles are nullified. Means what? Whatever the voltage it is there at the input side, same amplitude will be reached at the output side, but the unwanted signal will be nullified. So go for this one.
Sir, what is the can't tell us, sir.
Screen is not visible to you?
No, sir.
Visible, sir.
It's visible, sir. It's visible, sir.
It's okay, visible, okay. Sir.
No, sir.
No, sir. It is not visible.
No?
Yes, no, sir. Visible, sir.
Yes, sir. No, sir. Show.
ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಲಾಗೌಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತೀರಿ, ಯಾರಿಗೆ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವರು, ಅಥವಾ ನಂದು ಪಿನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಪಿನ್ ಮೈ ನೇಮ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಪಿನ್ ಅಂತ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ನೀವು ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಮೇಲೆ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಪಿನ್ ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾರ್ದು ಇದು ಕಾಣಬೇಕಂತ ಪಿನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು. ಕನ್ಸುತ್ತಾ? ನಂದು ನೇಮ್ನ ಪಿನ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ, ಏನೋ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ. So the diode is used to rectify the AC signal while the pulsating DC is taken across the load resistor. Okay, during the positive half cycle, so how the performance will be, how diode is going to rectify the things. So here the transformer, if you observe this diagram, so here we are going to use a few components like the AC input, and we are going to use one transformer and one diode and one load resistor. So across this load resistor, we are going to take output. Okay. Then how, what, which type of transformer we are using? So we are going to apply the AC. So by seeing this diagram, it is coupling transformer, means the secondary output is equal to primary input. Okay. So the step down transformer, what is the behavior of the step down transformer? Here the secondary output is very, very lesser than the primary input, that is step down. What about step up? The secondary output is more than the primary input, that is step up transformer. By seeing this transformer symbol, we can judge, yes, it is the coupling or transformer, coupling transformer. Couple nothing but just simply transfer. Okay. So here we are going to consider the secondary nodes as X and Y nodes. X and Y nodes. So if screen is not means you are completely you are observing, you can zoom your screen wherever I am pointing. Okay, to see the points where I am marking, you just zoom your screen. So here it is. Now you just concentrate on the circuit. So the secondary nodes are X and Y nodes of the transformer. So whatever the AC input we are going to apply, it will be available at the X and Y nodes. So what is the behavior of this circuit? So how these diode and resistors are connected? They are connected in series to this secondary of transformer. Okay. So let us go for this one. What is going to happen when the positive half cycle appears between 0 to pi duration? From 0 to pi duration, if I apply a sine wave, we are going to observe 0 to pi, there is a positive cycle. Okay, so what is going to happen with respect to the secondary of the transformer windings? So for the positive half cycle, the X end has polarity plus. This X end of the secondary of transformer is going to show the positive potential. Similarly, the Y is going to show negative potential. Okay, the polarity of these X and Y are plus and minus for positive cycle of the input. Next, what is going to happen? Obviously, what is the condition of the diode? When you apply a voltage with a bias, obviously this X and Y terminal are going to act as a bias to this diode circuit. So where plus is connected to a node of the diode. So what is going to happen when plus of the battery or bias, it is connected to the P-type semiconductor material, the diode, obviously it is in forward bias condition. So what is going to happen? So the input will be some, let me say the VM input, VM voltage, amplitude of this input is VM. So VM may be 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, or whatever may be the voltage. So based on the diode characteristics, so after reaching the new voltage, diode becomes what? Conductor. So here, as for all positive cycles, the polarity of X and Y terminals are going to be plus and minus. Hence, diode is always in forward bias condition. When diode is in forward bias condition, it is going to act as a conductor. So means whatever the current it is supplied by the AC input, all this current it is going to flow through this resistor RL. When current is flowing through this RL resistor, obviously output will be there, like output voltage will be there across RL. Therefore, at the output waveform, you can observe whatever the input you are applying, same will be available at the output side between the duration of positive cycles. Okay. So this is, what is the amplitude? It is as that of input. Output is equal to input with respect to amplitudes. Okay. Now, if I go for negative cycle of the input, so what is going to happen with cycle means between the duration pi to 2 pi. From 180 degree to 360 degree, we are going to have negative cycles. We are going to observe negative cycle is there. For the negative cycle, the X and Y terminals are become minus and plus. Reverse actually. The polarity of the x and y nodes are reverse for negative sample. So x becomes minus and y become plus. So what about the diode condition then? X is minus. X is minus terminal and y is plus terminal. Obviously, diode have got reverse bias conditions. Therefore, in the reverse bias condition, we know already the diode, it is going to act as an insulator, means no current is going to flow through this diode. When no current is flowing through this diode, obviously there is no current flowing through this load resistor. When no current, obviously how much output voltage we can expect when no current is flowing through this RL? Obviously it is zero. So in the graph you can observe when the input is having negative cycles, that is the duration between pi to 2 pi, the output signal is nullified. That is nothing but zero amplitude. And this phenomena continues for all the input positive and negative cycles. Okay, for positive cycle, diode becomes on, output will be there. For negative cycles, diode will be in the off, hence no output. Then we have some calculations with respect to this half wave rectifier. While designing the circuit based on our requirement, we need to judge. So what about this circuit? So what is the efficiency of this rectifier? So efficiency, how we are going to calculate? So it is the ratio of DC power to the applied input. AC power is known as rectifier efficiency, neta. Nothing but it is the ratio of output DC power divided by input AC power. So if I consider the input voltage, that is V, is equals to Vm sin theta. So as I said in the previous waveform, it is the amplitude of the input signal, it is Vm, and it is a sine wave. Okay, so therefore the mathematical expression for that signal, it is Vm sin theta. V the voltage across secondary winding and Vm is the maximum voltage. And we have some parameters with respect to diode. Obviously diode is going to have RF is the diode resistance and RL is the load resistance. Means two resistors are there in the circuit. If you look at only resistor components, so diode we may consider it is a resistor. So once we consider resistor, how much resistance value we can get? It is RF. Then what about this output DC power? We are going to label that one as PDC. So PDC is given by the DC current in the load resistor RL. So that is given by PDC is equal to IDC square into RL, where IDC is the output DC current and it is also called as average current, IAV. Average current, we may say it is, or we may call that one as a DC current. So if you go for the current in the circuit, it is Im sin theta. So be the current in the secondary winding, that is AC current, what we are going to say. So Im is the maximum current. To calculate output DC current, IDC, we have this expression. So it is calculated as the overall circuit AC current in the circuit, that is Im sin theta. We are going to take integration of this one from 0 to pi. So therefore, so I average current or DC current, it is given by 1 by 2 pi integration with the limits 0 to pi I d theta. Now, if you perform the mathematical steps with respect to I, so therefore the IDC is nothing but inverse of 2 pi integration 0 to pi Im sine theta d theta. So we are going to do the mathematical calculations. It is reduced to Im by 2 pi sine 0 to pi sine theta d theta. The value of sine theta with the limit 0 to pi, it is 2. So we are going to get the overall DC current. It is nothing but Im, that is maximum current in the circuit, divided by pi. Then if we substitute this one in the power equation, we come to know the DC power. It is given by Im by pi whole square into R. So this much power is there. Power is produced at the output side. If you calculate, because we need to go for the efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but output DC by input AC. So how to calculate input AC power? So the equation for this input AC power, it is PAC. The label input AC power, PAC, is equals to, we are going to consider the root mean square value of the current. So that is IRMS square into two resistors. Okay, it is RF plus RL. So if you look at the input side, we are going to observe two resistors are there in the next path. So that is RF diode resistance plus RL. Because why it is plus? Because both are connected in series. So total resistance, what it is going to there, and how much current is going to flow from the input side, it is root mean square of the current, that is IRMS. So here IRMS is RMS value of input current, and it is also called as average current at the input side. So to calculate RMS value of the input current, we have the equation IRMS is equals to square root of 1 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi I square dt. Why the limits are 0 to 2 pi? Because we are going to consider complete input signal. Complete input signal, it is exactly at the secondary of the secondary windings. Okay, so what we have calculated, it is IDC, it is the output current at the RL register. In the RL register, andre diode cross admele em baruttalre, diode cross admele, diode the output side irodu DC current, diode the input side irodu AC current. So to calculate that one, we have root mean square value. So it is 0 to 2 pi limit I square dt. Once again, we are going to substitute those equations. So if I go for to remove this square root, we just take squaring both sides, we get I RMS square is equals to 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to 2 pi I square dt. Okay, so once again, if you substitute this one with respect to I, it is I RMS square is nothing but 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to pi, we just substitute I by Im sine theta. So Im square sine square theta into d theta. Why it is 0 to pi now? Because here we are going to consider the diode is going to conduct the current between the duration 0 to pi. So after pi to 2 pi, there is no current. So Im is 0. So 0 into sine theta is, once again, the integration is going to reduce to 0. Okay. Then go for this calculation. Obviously, it is I square RMS. IRMS square is given by Im square by 2 pi integration 0 to pi sine square theta d theta. So by reducing this one, we come to know it is IRMS square, nothing but Im square by 4, or we need only what is the root mean square value of the current. It is Im by 2. So substituting, we get the AC power at the input side, it is Im square by Im by 2 square into Rf plus Rr. Now substituting these power equations in the efficiency ratio, it is given by efficiency output DC power divided by input AC power. We may get by substituting these equations, neta is equal to the output DC power, it is Im by pi square into RL divided by input AC power, it is Im by 2 square into Rf plus RL. We can reduce that one by once again. We just perform the mathematical calculations. Okay. So finally, we end up with the efficiency of this one is 0.406 divided by 1 plus Rf by RL. So what this ratio, is it possible to minimize this one? Yes. How? It is the efficiency is maximum if Rf is negligible as compared to RL, because Rf is what? It is the diode resistance, and RL is what? It is the load resistance. By comparing these two, Rf is a negligible quantity. Okay, because in the 0 to pi, it is conducting. Diode is in conduction. It is in forward bias condition. So obviously, how much resistance you can observe in the diode? So the diode is going to show minimum resistance. So minimum, it obviously it is when diode is conducting, means obviously theoretically or generally we may say it is zero resistance. So therefore it is a negligible part of the diode. So therefore, if you neglect RF, so what is the overall condition? It is the efficiency in the percentage, it is 40.6 is the maximum rectifier efficiency. We talk about the ripple factor. So what is the ripple factor? So the pulsating output of a rectifier consists of DC component and AC component, which is known as ripple. So this the ratio of RMS value of AC component to the DC component in the rectifier output is known as ripple factor. So how we are going to calculate it is the ratio of RMS value of the AC component to the DC component, that is ripple factor R. It is given by IAC divided by IDC for the ripple factor.
Sir, pulsating meaning
for ripple factor for half wave rectifier, it is defined as the effective value of total load current. It is given by the I RMS value, which is equals to square root of I square AC plus I square DC. Where IDC, it is the DC component, and IAC, it is the RMS value of the AC component. So by taking the square on both sides, we may get I RMS square is equal to IAC square and IDC square. Because we need the ratio. What ratio we need? It is IAC by IDC. So we need to go for that ratio in this respective equation. We have, if we divide both sides by I square DC, then we may get the equation. It is given by I RMS square divided by IDC square is equal to IAC square plus IDC square overall divided by IDC square. So if you go for mathematical terms, it is given by the equation IAC divided by IDC square is equal to I RMS divided by IDC whole square minus 1. Then by taking square root on the both sides, we may have, that is R is equals to IAC by IDC, which is equal to square root of I RMS divided by IDC square minus 1. So substituting this, what is I RMS and IDC, we may get, what is I RMS for half wave rectifier, what we defined in the previous calculation, it is the I RMS is given by Im by 2 and IDC is given by Im by pi whole square minus 1. So if you perform the mathematical calculations, you are reduced to the ripple factor for this half wave rectifier, it is 1.21. Means it is going to have both the ratio of how much AC and DC components are there in the output side. That is a ripple factor. It is ratio of AC current and DC current. That is 1.21. There is no unit for this one because it is a ratio of currents. So the ripple factor is 1.21 and efficiency is 40.6%. Then we have a full wave rectifier. So before going to this concept, we may go for some discussion about these concepts. So is there any difficulty to understand these concepts? How the
derivation is clear agartare illa sir.
Okay, fine. So what we are going to have, you need to, because the flow is I'm just go on flowing with the calculations, okay, but until unless you take a notebook and go on practicing, then only you will come to know. So if I do this same performance, yes, obviously you are going to get, because step by step, if I go on those things, nane calculation madidre nimge artha agutte anta ankondidini, but here adana direct torsidre enagutte, obviously it is going to give a little bit okay, how the calculations will be. So before going to those calculations, have you got this working phenomena of this diode as a half wave rectifier?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if I go for the brief, simple hellbekandre, it is just what? In the secondary winding, we have two nodes, X and Y nodes. So yenagutandre, for positive cycle, X becomes plus polarity and Y becomes minus polarity. So diode, what is going to happen? Diode is facing anode and cathode. So anode is facing plus potential and polarity, and cathode is facing negative polarity. Obviously, by seeing this circuit connection of the bias, obviously diode comes in forward bias condition. Forward bias condition will bandre enagutte, the diode is going to start conducting the current whatever it is given by the transformer. So all this current, it is flowing through this diode, and the same current is going to flow through this load resistor RL. Why it is same current? Because it is both are in series. So RL current hokta idandre, if we observe the output across RL, yes, obviously there is a output. So how much output? The input what you are supplying. So same thing we are drawn using the waveforms. Input in ide, output ade ide. When the input is positive cycle, negative cycle alli enagutte, these polarities becomes reverse. X enagutte minus polarity thonutte, and Y is going to consider plus polarity. When a diode anode is negative and cathode is positive, obviously diode it is in reverse bias condition. When it is a reverse bias condition, no current is going to flow through this diode. When no current is flowing, obviously there is no current through this RL. No current in the RL means output will be zero. So this is going to happen for all positive and negative cycles. So hence the output what you are going to observe for every 180 degree, you are going to get only positive cycles. Prati 180 degree. What about the innond 180 degree? Nimge output barade illa. Obviously there is a time, isn't it? 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi. This is the what we had the explanation. Then if you go for the efficiency of the rectifier, it is ratio of DC power divided by AC power. So how to calculate this output to DC power? Means at the output side, how much power is there? So how much power is there? It is with respect to the current at the output side. The DC current we are going to measure. Obviously, this rectifier is having both the currents, AC plus DC. That is nothing but what? Ripple factor. Eradu idori components. AC ni ide, DC ni ide. Okay, so what about this one? So output power, it is given by the output DC power we are only considering, not AC power. Okay, so the output DC power is PDC is equal to the DC current at the output side. So what is that DC current? It is IDC. So how to know this power? It is I into R calculation. So which I and which R? So output resistance RL into the output current, that to DC current, output DC current IDC. So if you go for power calculation, it is I square R. Obviously we know this mathematical equation. So I square R, so it is I square DC into R. Next, if we have the overall, as I that going to calculate that overall current, it is overall current in this circuit is I, which is given by Im sin theta. What is this Im? It is the maximum current, peak of amplitude of the, okay, so Im sin theta. So how to calculate this IDC? IDC calculation 2 pi, 0 to pi. Why the limit is 0 to pi only? Because the input signal is having 360 degree, 0 to 2 pi. But we are calculating the current only for 0 to pi limits, because output is there between that duration itself. Even though if you consider 2 pi, because after pi to 2 pi, there is no current. There is no current means what is the overall mathematical equation? It is 0. So we are not considering that part. So the limit is up to only 0 to pi. So 0 to pi I dt. Okay, it is the integration of the current itself. That's it. The DC current is nothing but integration of the circuit current in divided by 2 pi. Okay. And we are going on substituting the mathematical calculations. We just replacing overall integration of the current. So same thing we are performing here. Integration of the current divided by 2 pi. Okay, Then similarly, the AC current, how to calculate? It is root mean square value of the input current. So how to calculate that root mean square value? It is once again square root of integration of the overall circuit current. Overall circuit current. Okay. So we are going simplifying the things, and we are going to get finally the overall efficiency from this rectifier. It is 40.6%. Then if you go for ripple factor, how much ripple factor is there? Nothing but the pulsating output of the rectifier consists of DC component and AC components. So the ripple factor, the ratio, new ratio to AC matu DC the comparison madadaga, the ratio what you are going to consider it is ripple factor, which is equals to 1.21. But same thing is going to differ in the next concept, that is full wave rectifier. So in the full wave rectifier, we have two types of circuits. One is center tapped, or sometimes it is called as a two diode full wave rectifier, and another one is bridge rectifier. So in the center tapped, the circuit look like this. Before going to circuit, you just observe the waveforms. So here only positive cycles are there. Only positive cycles are there. Okay, so how to get this one? So discuss these things in the
sir, your voice is breaking, sir. Your voice is breaking, sir.
Okay, fine. So I'm using the system audio mic. Maybe because of the distance, it may be breaking. Okay. So let me have only one small query. If I want output only negative cycles, what I need to do?
By reversing the diode, sir.
By reversing the
diode, sir.
Reversing the diode. Obviously, if I reverse the diode, what is going to happen? Let me clear all these things. Actually, it is just extra thing what I am asking. It is all okay. So what is going to happen for the positive cycle? X becomes plus and Y becomes minus. If diode it is in reverse connection. ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೀಗಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನೋಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಪೊಲಾರಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಆನೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೇಸಿಂಗ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಪೊಲಾರಿಟಿ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಸೊ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫ್ಲೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ resistor RL. There is no current in the circuit. So no current and then we output to baralri. It will be zero for 0 to 2 pi. What about negative cycle? Negative cycle is minus agate, plus agate. So it is plus agate. Plus plus connected, minus minus connected. Means it is in forward bias condition. Obviously current is going to flow in this direction. So when current is flowing, obviously what you are going to observe, yes, the output will be there. Nimge en output barutte, nim input en kottidira ade barutte. So input en kottidira negative cycle kottidira, so output em barutte, you are going to observe negative cycles. Once again, what is going to happen with the positive cycle? Once again, output is zero. So this is the small change in the diode connection. Notice chikkadide circuit ಡಯೋಡ್ನ ಕೊಡೋ ರೀತಿ ಮೇಲಿದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬೇಕು ಸೊ if you observe these two conditions, you get a sacrum again. What is the vast area of this electronic field? Vast area of this electronic field. Hang if working phenomenon hang here at theory. Notably, if you go for only, so output name birthday there for if diode it is in whatever in the previous diagram. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇದ್ರ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಸಿಗಲ್ಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ತವೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಏನು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇರ್ತವೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಝೀರೋ ಟು ವಿ ಎಮ್ ಝೀರೋ ಟು ವಿ ಎಮ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ವಿ ಎಮ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವಿ ಎಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಡಯೋಡ್ ನೀವು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದೇ ಡಯೋಡ್ನ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಬರ್ತವೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಬರ್ತವೆ ಝೀರೋ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ವಿ ಎಮ್ ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ನನಗೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಕೇಳ್ತೀರಿ ನಾನು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರಷ್ಟು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಕೇಳುತ್ತೆ ನನಗೆ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರಷ್ಟು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರೋದು ವಿಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಸೊ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಕೇಳಿದವ್ರಿಗೆ ಡಯೋಡ್ನ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ನ ನೀವು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಅದು ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋ ಆನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಬೇಕು ನಿಮಗೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರಷ್ಟೇ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುತ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಡಯೋಡ್ನ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಸೈಕಲಿಗೆ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗುವಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ವೈಲ್ ಡಿಸೈನಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಡಯೋಡ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ತಿರುಗಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕೆಲಸನೇ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೀರ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ಏಕದಮ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟಿಲ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ದಿ ಡಯೋಡ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇವಾಗ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಡಯೋಡ್ನೇ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಪರಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದರೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಂದೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ಬಾರ್ದ್ರಿ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದೀಸ್ ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವೈಲ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ಓಕೆ ರೀ ಫೈನ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಡೀಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಫುಲ್ ವೇವ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್